Okay, it's time for the deleted scene section.
Sometimes we end up taking scenes out to tell a story more effectively.
So, hey, have a look and let's see what you think.
So, hey. What's with the so, hey? So, hey.
Oh, I forgot to snap. This next scene is a scene where Mayor Turkey Lurkey gets together with Buck and really shares some heartfelt information with Buck.
And initially, we thought it would be a good idea if the mayor gave Buck this information. But as we developed the story, we really realized this is a story between a father and a son. And the scene ultimately had to be one between Chicken Little and his dad.
The two principals, yeah. And it was a really hard sequence to let go because Dick Zondag, who's a brilliant animator, had animated Mayor Lurkey. And just, it's fantastic animation that we really loved. And I want you to know, when we cut out some of these sequences, it's really hard for us to do it. Mm-hmm. We love it as a sequence, it just didn't strongly fit the storyline. Mm-hmm.
There's a great performance by Don Knotts and great animation by Dick Zondag, and it was really hard to cut this one out.
I feel for you, Buck. I really do. Yeah, it must be tough to raise a son like that all alone. Yep. Hey, don't blame yourself. No. You tried. You did everything you could do, right? Supported him unconditionally, as a father should. You get your hopes up, then he lets you down over and over again. The truth is, a kid that small should stick to things more suited to his size and ability, you know, like stamp collecting and whatnot. You know, frankly, I don't know how you handle disappointments so well. Yeah. Look, I know you want him to fit in, but do yourself a favor. Don't get your hopes up too high, right? Yeah. Well, I best be getting back to Marin. There's a lot of ruffled feathers out there.
This next scene is entirely in storyboards, and it was done about 4 years ago. And at that time, Chicken Little was a girl, and she had a mother named Chloe, played by Estelle Harris.
But ultimately, as we continued on the movie, we realized the heart of the movie was the broken relationship between a father who meant well but didn't quite know the right things to say, and Chicken Little. And as long as the mother was there, she was sort of a buffer. She kept things smoothed out and kept the father from really having to deal with Chicken Little.
That sometimes gets the best of me, and last time I checked, that does not make me a freak! I'm not a freak. I'm not a freak.
Heads up, dudes! Freaky kid talking to herself.
I'm not a freak.
Oh, look at that. Crazy.
Okay, here we go again.
Chicken Little, your father is home.
Your father, who is not a burglar,
is home from work and is opening the front door. What you see is your father's briefcase. Nothing to be alarmed about. Everything is okay. Situation normal.
Chuck, she isn't home from school yet.
Thank goodness. I just need a 10-minute lie down. Last night was crazy.
Oh, Chuck.
Come on, please.
We need to talk.
We can talk in 11 minutes.
Oh.
Just please. Come on, you're a peach, honey.
Our daughter is at a crisis point. She needs to know we love her.
Love her? Love her? Of course I'd love her. She's my baby. Who stayed at her side for those extra 18 days when she was too afraid to peck out of her shell? I did. That's who. This is not about my love for her.
Well, when you get upset like this morning, it's hard to tell.
I had reason to be upset.
Last night I was attacked and thrown down the stairs because I was a space alien coming to put her brain in a blender. The night before, she thought I was a werewolf coming to suck her blood.
Vampire.
What?
A vampire sucks your blood. A werewolf tears you apart limb from limb in an uncontrollable blind rage.
Vampires, werewolves, monsters in the closet, who cares? When that imagination of hers takes over, it's dangerous to be around her.
Shame on you. Great things come from great minds. She'll surprise you someday, you'll see. That imagination of hers is a gift.
A gift I'd like to exchange for one that won't kill me. Look, all I want is to have a regular life like everyone else. A regular kid like everyone else. We only got one kid. Why can't she be like everyone else?
Daddy?
Hi. I wrote you a letter. But I thought you might not want to see me. So I left it under your door. I didn't frighten you, did I?
No. What's it say?
Huh? Oh. Well, let's see. I got a little long-winded, you know. It basically says, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry too, Daddy. I'll never embarrass you again, I promise.
Oh, it's okay, Chicken Little. Really, you're my little chick-chick, so it's okay. Good night, sweetheart.
Good night. Daddy?
Huh?
Larry isn't very tired and... Well, he wants you to tell him a story.
Oh, well... Would Larry like to hear the one about the pancake that sailed around the world?
High adventure. Larry would love that one.
Well, all right. Now, as Larry probably remembers, Captain Pancake and his first mate, Mr. Waffle...
Oh, yeah.
...were thrown off course by a furious storm.
Ooh.
And he was forced to dock for repairs in a port known to be teeming with knives and forks.
In this scene, Chicken Little has just overheard her parents worried about her. So she goes up to her computer and she types in a search, and she wants to find, is there a way she can change?
And I really hated to lose this scene. It was really emotional and very cute. But in the evolution of the story, ultimately, it had to go. Take a look.
Oh, come on.
Oh, wow. Oh,
please.
Please.
Taunt my baby, will you?
Just calm down.
Oh, don't they realize she's just a little girl?
Yeah, I know. A little girl that did $3.6 million in property damage this month alone.
Well, we can't just give up on her. We have to find some way to prove she's better by the end of the summer, and then everything will be fine.
Chloe, come on. We've tried everything. I'm all out of ideas with that kid. It's hopeless. She is the way she is. She'll never change.
The right setting for our next sequence, the perfect setting, seemed like the lunchroom. However,
we ended up feeling that this was a scene with a bunch of characters sitting around and talking. So we ended up taking a lot of these elements and putting them into dodgeball class, where there was a lot to watch while they talked.
We had some fun eating business that went on with the characters, so we kind of hated to give that up. But ultimately, the scene just felt too static, and it really benefited from the action that went on in the dodgeball game.
So did you guys hear? My life story. Soon to be a major motion picture.
You're gonna be a star? I can't believe it!
Woo!
Woo! Slap me some rind!
Okay, you're obviously not happy about it.
Gotcha.
You know what I need?
Thank you.
A chance. One chance to do something cool. To make everyone forget.
Won't help. Here, 8 straws, right?
Yeah, it will. Hear me out, okay? If one moment can destroy my life, right?
Mm-hmm.
All it should take is another moment, a great second moment.
Uh-huh, I see where you're going.
To erase the previous first moment. Hence, my life would be good.
That makes total sense.
Yeah, actually, Runt, it doesn't.
She's right.
You just can't replace one dumb moment with one great one and think that'll just fix everything, because that's not how it works.
Yes, but
you can't live that way.
The lady speaks the truth.
Besides, you don't have to prove anything. You're a good person, and if everyone else can't see that, then that's their problem.
She's right.
No, she's not.
No, she's not.
Runt.
Well, I mean, that's just my opinion.
Look, thanks, Abby, but I just need a chance, that's all.
Come on, you should try and get a break from all this. Hey, there's a couple of new flicks opening over at the Bijou if you're not doing anything Friday.
Oh, hey, you guys going on a date?
No.
It's on a date, right?
Are you mad?
We're going Dutch.
Yes.
Yeah.
did I interrupt something? Looks like you two were having a moment.
What's your problem, Loxie?
Let's go.
Hey, let us not take up arms, or wings, or hooves, or...
I'd listen to the coward, and your,
Friends?
Whatever that is.
Hey, he's a fish!
I am a coward.
But he's a fish!
Let me go, Runt!
Really, dear? There's no need to get ugly! Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean it like that.
You know what? We've all had just about enough.
Oh.
love you!
When we started making Chicken Little, we had a lot of debates over how many people in the world know the Chicken Little story. And so we started out and we thought, well, let's do a storybook opening in a different style than the movie and sort of take you through the basic beats before we actually went into the movie itself.
And as a nod to the 2D history of Disney Studios, we thought we would start in a traditional animated fashion and then evolve into the 3D format.
And we had Don Knotts narrate this opening. And it was charming, but eventually we decided that it seemed a little young. It was sort of like a storybook opening, a little bit young, and that it was more compelling, more exciting to actually show the event of Chicken Little thinking the sky had fallen in the film rather than in storybook form.
Take a look.
Once upon a time, in the peaceful town of Oaky Oaks, a chicken of minuscule proportions was born. Over the years, as the rest of his classmates grew larger in the normal fashion, he pretty much stayed his original size. And so, everyone called him Chicken Little. One fine morning, as teeny Chicken Little sat beneath an enormous oak tree, an acorn fell, striking him square on his smaller than average head. Although it was only an acorn, the silly little chicken thought it was a piece of the sky. "Oh dear," he exclaimed, "the sky is falling." He ran from one end of the town to the other, warning everyone, "The sky is falling, the sky is falling, the sky is falling." He told Goosey Lucy and Drakey Lakey, Foxy Loxy and Ducky Lucky. Soon, Oaky Oaks was in a panic. Fortunately, wise old Mayor Turkey Lurkey calmed everyone down. "The sky is not falling," he explained. "It was just a simple acorn." When the townsfolk realized what had happened, they laughed and laughed and laughed at Chicken Little's stupidity. His father was terribly embarrassed. From then on, Chicken Little was known to all as a laughingstock, a town fool, the joke of Oaky Oaks.
A movie? Ugh. When am I ever gonna live this down?
Okay, this segment, I honestly have no idea why we put this in the movie. I've completely forgotten why we did it. I even boarded some of it.
Wow.
Why was this in the movie?
I remember why we originally thought we should put it in the movie. Buck, Chicken Little's father, we sort of tuned him up and down. Sometimes he seemed in the story a little too mean. Sometimes a little too nice. At the beginning of the movie, we wanted to make him a great father that cared about Chicken Little, but a guy that didn't quite understand all the elements that it took to be a good, loving father. And one of the things we thought maybe was a little mean for a while, so we thought, well, let's have him at least struggling to cook Chicken Little breakfast. That would be a nice thing for a single parent father to try to do. But I think what happened was we got real carried away, and pretty soon he's cooking, and it's a cooking show, and there's a chef, and we turned it into a very long comedy sequence, and at some point we all looked at it and went, whoa, what movie is this? It just sort of wandered off the spine of where we were trying to go with the story, and it was taking us way too long to get into the movie, and it was entertaining, it just didn't have too much to do with our movie. That's why you forgot.
Did you just make that all up?
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Cooking with Klaus. Today we make the papofa. Let us begin. Is everyone at home ready?
I'm ready. Oh, I'm ready.
Ingredients lined up like so?
Fairly certain I'm ready.
Chef Little, here to help, Dad.
I got it.
Timer set for 4 minutes.
Okay.
And we begin. Yeah? Mix together the flour, sugar, butter, and yeast.
Done.
And stir while adding 3 eggs.
Eggs?
But if you don't want to add eggs.
No, we don't.
Add more buttermilk.
Okay.
Next comes the tricky part.
Tricky part? What tricky part?
Dad, it's actually fine. I could just have feed.
It's okay, I got it.
Take one gloppin and the motion of the cinnamon and the schnurr of the cayenne.
Come on, wait a minute.
Gloppin here, gloppin there, smack and smack and schnurr, stir! Pop it into a preheated oven at 4,000 degrees for 2 seconds. And in just moments, you have it!
Yeah.
Ooh.
Hey, all right.
My tail's on fire!
Good morning. I'm Don Bow Wowzer. In today's headlines, it was 1 year ago today that mass destruction swept the town of Oaky Oaks. Chicken Little is the child's name, and if it weren't for Chicken Little, none of this would have happened. Let's roll the tape.
Run! Look out! The sky is falling! The sky is falling! This way, everyone! It happened under the old oak tree!
Son, turn the channel. Turn it off. Help it!
It's here. I know it's here. There's a piece of the sky somewhere on the ground here. It was shaped like that!
It looks like a stop sign?
Yes! Only it doesn't say stop, and it's blue, and it has a cloud on it. And it hit me on the head, and it looks like a stop sign.
Son, is this what hit you?
What? No, Dad, it was definitely a piece of the sky.
Piece of the sky. It's okay, everyone.
Dad, no.
There's been like a little mistake. No. It was just an acorn that hit my son. A little acorn.
Dad, no.
Quiet, son. This is embarrassing enough already.
I've seen it before. Acorn plus single parrot equals madness. And let's not forget the boy's unusually small size. That's just weird.
Chicken Little, what were you thinking?
Why would you put your town's safety in jeopardy?
How could you mistake a stop sign for an acorn?
But it'd be a big acorn, little fla.
What did he say?
Big acorn, little fla.
It was a big acorn?
It was an ape throwing coleslaw?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's just gibberish. Gibberish of an insane person.
Oh, Chicken Little. He is crazy.
What? No. Hey, no! Turn that off! Get out of here with that!
Wasn't that fun? Now, don't forget to tune in next week when we will make...
I hadn't seen that last clip before.
Son, Son, come on.
I'm gonna go get the paper.
No, son, come back, please. I didn't know they were... taping me.
We interrupt this program to bring you late-breaking news. We're reporting to you live from the home of Chicken Little in the hopes of getting an interview with the crazy little chicken himself.
Did you actually think the sky was falling?
Did you know it was an acorn?
Are you concerned about sky falling copycats?
Are you any relation to the boy who cried wolf?
Are you really a chicken?
Look over there!
Huh? Where'd he go?
There he is!
Chicken Little, what's your reaction to the news that a movie is going to be made of your amazing mistake?
A movie?
Is it true? That can't be true.
It is and it is. By this time next summer, everyone on the planet will know of your colossal blunder.
Enough! Get out of here! Leave us alone!
Dad, mail slot.
Huh? Mr. Clark, how do you feel about the movie?
Who do you think should play your part?
Sean Penguin?
Brad Pitbull?
Russell Crowe?
Russell Crowe? Really? Get off my porch!
No, Dad,
mail slot.
Go away!
This is our original opening to the movie When Chicken Little Was a Girl. It's a little scary.
shutters blowing against the house. Yeah, yeah. That is not a vampire rising from his coffin. That is just a house settling. That is not a hungry wolf. That is just an old branch swaying in the wind. Everything is safe. Everything is normal. Everything is just... What was that? It's an alien.
So this next scene is all in storyboards, and the intention of this scene was to introduce the characters, especially of Runt and Fish, and show Runt's inability to do anything, and show that Fish was capable of almost everything.
There you are. We were so worried about you. Woo!
You okay?
Yeah, sure, no problem. Paper. It's the new black.
Come on. Let's go get some lunch. Okay, so I picked up an extra worksheet for you in mutton class, and we have to read a couple of chapters for Cockle Doodle.
Okay. Snack machine! I can't believe this! I will not let you defeat me this time! Okay, you win! Oh, hey! Oh, hi, Fish. How can I ever repay you?